Hello guys, welcome back to my channel. In this video, I will show you how to expand a binomial expression using the binomial theorem. Let's define what is binomial theorem. The binomial theorem is the method of expanding a binomial expression which has been raised to any finite power. So in symbols, we have the quantity of a plus b raised to n. So if we're going to expand this, so this becomes n tapos 0 a raised to n. So how do we read this? Actually, this notation or nr, ang basa natin dyan, yung notation na to ay binomial coefficient. And it will read as the combination of n taken r at a time. Okay, the combination of n taken 0 at a time. So times the quantity of a raised to n. So, ang basa natin dito, or ang tawag natin dito guys, yan ay binomial coefficient. Okay, so kapag in-expand natin to, ito yung kakalabasan niya guys. Okay, so mag-stop tayo dito sa parehong number dapat. Okay, so depende kung ang exponent mo ay 5, so dapat ito ay 5-5. Kung ito ay 8, dapat ito ay 8-8 din. Okay, gets? So, kaya nga we have binomial, which means we have two terms. The first term and then the second term. Okay, so we have here restriction. So, kapag in-expand natin to guys, this becomes n factorial all over r factorial times the quantity of n minus r factorial. Where r is greater than or equal to 0, but less than or equal to n. Let's have our example. Expand the quantity of 4x plus 3 to the fifth power using the binomial theorem. Okay, so to show this, let's have the solution. So identify muna natin which are your a and b. So yung a natin dito guys ay, ang a natin ay 4x. And then your b is positive 3. So, kung minus 3 dito guys, or negative 3, of course, your b is negative 3. And of course, our n, or the exponent, that is equal to 5. So, since 5 yung nasa given natin, no? Okay, so, this becomes 4x plus 3 close to the 5th power equals yung n, tapos 0 natin, of course, our n is equal to 5. Of course, lagi tayo mag-start sa 0. And then, your a raised to n, your a here is 4x. So, 4x. Lagi natin ng parenthesis, kasi it makes sense. And your n here, of course, that is equal to 5. Okay, and then actually b raised to 0 to, so di ba any number raised to a 0 power is always 1 or is equal to 1, so kahit hindi natin isulat yon. And then plus, so yung n natin hanggang 5, so mag-stop tayo ng 5 guys, so 5 tapos 1, and then yung a natin, guys, yung a natin, which is 4x. 4x. So, by the way, guys, yung a natin, yung exponent niya ay decreasing. So, pababa. So, pababa siya, guys. No? And then, for our b, yung b naman na exponent natin ay pataas. So, 1, 2, okay, depende yan kung ilan. And then, so, 5. So, this becomes 4. And then, your b, guys, is 3, no? Times 3 raised to 1. Okay, actually, dito kasi 0 yan. 0 tapos 1. And then, plus 5. Of course, 2. So, 0, 1, 2. And then your A here guys is 4x. Huwag kayong malilito. Close, raise to the third power. Kasi 5, 4, 3. And then yung B na exponent natin ay increasing naman. Opposite nyo nito. And then your B is 3. Of course, so 0 dito. Ito ay 1. Ito ay 2. So, plus 5. Of course, magiging 3 na to. And then, your A here is 4x, right? 4x, and then our exponent becomes 2. So, decreasing yung exponent natin for our A variable. And then, your B here is 3. Of course, 1, 2, 3, 0, 1, 2, and then 3. And then plus, hindi nakakasya, so sulat ko rito. So 5, 4, okay, tapos tayo sa 3. And then your A is 4x. Close, raise to 1. Okay, so 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And then your B here is 3. And exponent becomes 4. So, increasing siya guys. Plus, of course, 5. And then 5. So, mag-stop na tayo dito guys. Tignan nyo, magkapareha sila. And then, your A is 4x raised to 0. Okay? Or actually guys, kahit hindi natin ipakita o isulat dito. Kasi, di ba, any number raised to 0 power is always 1. Pwede nang wag nang isulat. Okay? Or if you want, pwede namang isulat. And then, of course, your B is 3. And, of course, our exponent is, kung may 4 ka na, of course, 5. Okay, nako ba guys? And then, the next process, kung wala kayong calculator, okay, gagamitin natin yung formula na to para i-simplify natin to. Okay, kung wala lang kayong calculator, so, paano natin kinocompute? Ganito lang yan, guys. So, halimbawa, so, N, of course, R equals N factorial divided by R factorial times the quantity of N minus R factorial. So, yung una natin dito guys ay 5, 0. Okay, so 5, 0. So, ibig sabihin, the combination of 5 taken 0, no? Okay, so your N is 5 all over. What's your R? Of course, 0. 0 factorial. And then, 5 minus 0 factorial. So, simplify lang natin to guys. Sorry, I forgot to write factorial. So, 5 factorial, that is 5 times 4 times 3 times 2 times 1. All over, 0 factorial is equal to 1. So, 5 minus 0 is 5, of course. So, times 5 na yun, di ba? So, 5 factorial. So, expand natin. Times 4, times 3, times 2, times 1. So, pwede tayo mag-cancel out dyan, guys. Cancel natin yan, cancel natin yan. So, 1 divided by 1. So, the answer is 1. So, kapag in-evaluate natin to guys, itong 5, the combination of 5, the combination of 5 taken at 0, so, magiging 1 na lang siya. Okay? Actually, pwede nating wag nang isulat, no? Pwedeng wag sulat, pwedeng isulat din. Okay? And then, times. Sulat muna natin to, guys. Mamaya tayo mag-simplify. 4x raised to the quantity 4x raised to the 5th power. And then later, ituturo ko sa inyo using cycle. Kahit hindi na natin gamitin ito. Okay? Itong formula na ito. Kung meron kayong calculator. Pero kapag sinabi ng teacher nyo na pakita nyo ito, so, no choice kayo. Gagawin nyo ito. Okay? So, later, gagamit tayo ng cycle. And then, plus, ito. Okay? Gamit tayo ng cycle or the scientific calculator. So, ibig sabihin, guys, hanapin niyo yung combination dito. Yung combination ay nandoon sa division, sa divide, no? So, just encode or press 5 and then shift. Pindutin niyo to yung divide. So, magkakaroon ng si doon. And then, of course, 1. So, enter. It will give us 5. So, magiging 5 na siya times ito, 4x raised to 4 and then times 3. Okay? Nakuha ba, guys? Okay, kung gagamitin naman natin to, let's say wala kayong calculator, no? So, pwede naman magma-manual computation tayo. Ito yun. So, 5 tapos 1 equals 5 factorial all over your r is equal to 1 factorial and then 5 minus 1 close factorial. Kapag in-evaluate natin yun, guys, magiging 5 times 4 times 3 times 2 times 1 all over, of course, what is 1 factorial? That is also 1. And then 5 minus 1, that is equal to 4. So 4 factorial. So times 4 times 3 times 2 times 1. So actually, pwede naman ganito. 5 times 4, 20 times 3, 60 times 2, 120. No? 120. Times 1 is equal to 120. Okay? So, 1 times 4, 4 times 3, 12. 12 times 2, 24 times 1, that is equal to 24. So, pwede natin i-divide yan. That is equal to 120 divided by 24 equals 5. Okay? Actually, pwede na natin hindi multiply yan. Mag-cancellation method tayo. So, 4 times 3 times 2 times 1. Tapos ito. So, 5 divided by 1. 5 din naman, right? Okay. So, gets? So, kapag ito sinimplify natin, ito yung magiging result. And then, so, gamit ulit tayo ng calculator. So, nandito na tayo, guys. So, 5, 2. So, press 5, shift, and then combination 2. So, that is equal to 10. Copy nyo muna yan. Mamaya tayo mag-evaluate. Raise to the third power. Okay, 3 squared. Plus. Okay, so 5. Edit ko na lang to. Delete natin yung 2. Gawin natin 3. So, that is equal to 10 also. Times 4x close squared times 3 raised to the third power. Okay, so plus Okay, malilito guys. Okay, itong 5 combination ng 4. Delete ko yung 3, gawin kong 4. Enter. That is equal to 5. And then, copy nyo lang yan, 4x raised to 1, and then 3 raised to 4. Okay? And then, for the last term, dito na lang, hindi na kasha doon. Okay, so, kapag ganito guys, magkapares na siya. So, automatic magiging 1 to. So, 1. Prove natin using cycle. Scientific calculator. Edit ko yung 4. Gagawin kong 5. So, 1. Okay? And then, 4x raise to 0. Pwede natin evaluate na yan. Sige. Okay, kahit mamaya na para sabay-sabay. Para hindi kayo malito. And then 3 to the 5th power. Okay, let's simplify. So 1 times 4x to the 5th power. Okay, evaluate natin to. Okay, let's use calculator. Ibig sabihin nito guys, 4 raised to 5, x raised to 5. Okay, 4 raised to the 5th power. That is equal to 1,024. So, 1,024 x raised to the 5th power. That will be your first term. Plus, okay, 4 raised to 4. Gamit ang calculator, guys. So, 4 raised to 4. That is 256. Times 5. May 5 pa tayo rito. 1,280. Times 3. May 3 pa. Kasi 3 raised to 1 is equal to 3. So, 3,840. Of course, the exponent and the variable x becomes x raised to the 4th power. Nakuha ba guys? Plus, ito evaluate natin yan. Okay, 4 cubed, that is equal to 64, right? So, 64 times 10, 640, times what is 3 squared? So, 3 times 3 is 9. So, times 9. That is 5,760. So, 5,760. And x raised to the 3rd power. Okay? Plus, eto guys, simplify natin to. So, what is 4 squared? That is 16. No? 16. So, 4 squared. That is 16. Times 10. 160. And then 3 cubed. That is 3 times 3 is 9. Times 3 is 27. And then times 27. So it will give us 4,320. 4,320 x raised to the, of course, 2nd power. And then plus, so 4x raised to 1 is 4x times 520, right? So that is 20 times 3 raised to 4 is 81. multiply natin, magiging 1,620. So, 1,620, of course, do not forget the variable x, raised to 1. Actually, kahit wala nang 1 dyan, meron ka ng 1 talaga dito. Okay? And then, ito yung sinasabi ko kanina guys, any number raised to a 0 power is always 1. Okay, so 1 ang magiging sagot natin dito, times 1 is 1 pa rin. Times raised to the 5th power, that is equal to 3 to the 5th power. Or 3 to the 5th power, evaluate natin yan, 3 raised to the 5th power, that is 243. So, plus 243. So, kapag in-expand natin ang 4x plus 3 raised to the 5th power, ito yung magiging sagot niya guys. Okay, 1024x to the 5th power plus 3840x to the 4th power plus 5760x cubed plus 4320x squared plus 1620x plus 243. So, ganun lang kasimple guys. Okay, huwag kayong paparito. So, this is the end of our video. I hope na meron kayong natutunan. Thank you for watching.